Autoline Daily is brought to you by Bridgestone, passion for excellence.
Here are today's top headlines. GM could get split in two. The UAW loses a significant number of members, and Honda taps into the human brain. Up next, we'll be back with the news behind the headlines. This is Autoline Daily for Wednesday, April 1st, 2009, and now the real news. General Motors could be split into two companies, says a report from Reuters. A new legal entity would be formed that contains all the company's profitable operations, like Cadillac, Chevrolet, GMC, and Buick. And a so-called old GM would retain the company's money-losing operations, like Hummer and Saturn. The old GM would be taken into bankruptcy, while the new one would not, which could avoid the problem that assumes consumers will not buy a car from a bankrupt company. A report from the U.S. Department of Labor says membership in the United Auto Workers Union fell 7% last year to only 431,000 workers. In the last 3 years, the UAW has lost over 100,000 members. You know, a few years ago, an analyst told me that the union would not be viable if its membership fell under 500,000 members. However, the Detroit Free Press reports that the UAW is cutting its spending to reflect the loss in membership. And besides, the union says the government underreports its membership and that it actually has more than 500,000 members. Hyundai is one of a few companies that's seen its sales rise in the U.S. this year, and its assurance program, which takes over car payments if a buyer loses their job, is credited for the boost. Now Ford and GM will offer their own versions. Ford will cover payments up to $700 a month for up to 12 months if a customer loses a job. GM will pay $500 a month for 9 months. GM will also help protect the retail value of the vehicle at trade-in after the customer is halfway through the finance contract. In Japan, Mazda is offering commercial leasing of its Premacy Hydrogen RE Hybrid. The hybrid system boosts the hydrogen fuel range of the vehicle to 200 kilometers or about 124 miles. It can also run on gas if hydrogen is not available. The first units will be delivered to government authorities and energy-related companies. A subsidiary of Honda R&D, the Advanced Telecommunications Research Institute International, and the Shimadzu Corporation have developed the world's first brain-machine interface, which can control a robot by human thought. Sensors are placed on the user's head. Then the user imagines moving a body part but without making any physical movement. Changes in both brain waves and blood flow are analyzed and transmitted to Honda's Osimo robot, which can raise its arms or legs. Honda is looking into applying this technology to a human interface through integration with other technologies like artificial intelligence or robotic technologies. And I assure you, this is not an April Fool's joke. Coming up next, it's time for You Said It.
Changing tires out here could be dangerous, but with these tires, I don't need to worry.
Bridgestone. And now it's time for some of your feedback. We get all kinds of comments from you guys, and You Said It gives me a chance to respond. Sam Arbuckle wrote in from Florida to say, I come from a long line of auto line workers and wonder about the quality of the 2010s with all the layoffs the line workers face daily. Think I'll stick to buying a couple of years back for now till we see proof all the nuts and bolts are there. You know, Sam, as a former line worker, I'm surprised to hear you say that. No matter what the critics say about UAW workers, I've been impressed to see that quality continues to improve at UAW plants despite those layoffs. Look at the latest J.D. Power numbers. Buick, Cadillac, Mercury, Lincoln, and Ford beat out most of their competitors. And then we got this audio comment from Jim Thykeson from Venice, Florida.
I was amazed to find out that the hydrogen-celled car, as far as the Honda Clarity is concerned, actually fills up with natural gas and then takes and converts the natural gas via the fuel cell into electricity that runs the motors, putting the electric car really into a position of non-viability. Don't you think that's a good idea, instead of messing around with all of these mirrors and windmills and pie-in-the-sky crap? Natural gas is the only thing that's going to do it. Russia and Europe are so far ahead of us, it's insane. It's time to get the U.S. back on the same page.
Jim, thanks for your comment. But my way of looking at it is, let the marketplace decide. Give consumers the choices and let them choose. And then Ed Kay wrote in to say, speaking of the Cadillac CTS, what do you know about the station wagon version of the car? I saw one on my drive to work today. Looked pretty sharp if you like that kind of thing. Ed, the CTS wagon is a clever conversion that keeps the same body side aperture as the sedan. That dictates keeping the same rear doors, which saves a ton of tooling costs, but also constricts the design. But if people like the way it looks, then they did a pretty good job. Well, that's it for today's top news in the global auto industry. Don't forget, though, to tune into Out of Line After Hours Thursday night at 7 p.m. Eastern Time, when we go live with Peter DeLorenzo from Auto Extremist. PR veteran Jason Vines will join us, as will John Neff from Autoblog, talking about the big blow-up at General Motors this week. Anyway, thanks for watching. We'll see you tomorrow.
Visit our website for even more great content all week long. Autoline Extra, Don's Journal, podcasts, and even more. So click over and get the inside view at AutolineDetroit.tv.